Today I want to discuss from the Chaitanya Charitamrita another very, very powerful lesson which will make some of you, which will give you a very good point to think about.
Ja bih danas želeo da razgovaram još jednoj lekciji iz Chaitanya Charitamrite i koja će iznati jednu poentu koja je jako, jako dobro da o njoj razmislite.
It is how to act towards the spiritual master and how to not act towards the spiritual master.
I čitav čas će biti o tome kako da se ponašate prema duhovnom učitelju i kako da se ne ponašate prema njemu.
Yes. Let me just, before I start. So, Hari Bol, Nandini, jetzt ich spreche Englisch. Ist das für dich okay? Gut. Gut. Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda.
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda.
Jaya Chaitanya Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vrinda.
Jaya Chaitanya Jaya Gaur Bhakta Vrinda.
Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda.
Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda.
Jaya 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 Jaya
Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya
Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya Jaya
Jaya Jaya Jaya
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare
Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare.
Krishna manifests in different forms. One is the Diksha Guru, the other is the Shiksha Gurus, and also the Vaishnavas. And in whatever form the Lord comes to us, we should try to please Him.
Krishna se manifestuje u različitim oblicima kao Diksha Guru, kao Shiksha Guru, kao Vaishnavi, u kome god oblik da se on pojavi, mi uvek trebamo da se trudimo da ga zadovoljimo.
Especially we should try to please thank you so much the spiritual master, because by his blessings we can make advancement. Without his blessings, advancement becomes extremely difficult.
I mi bismo posebno trebali da se trudimo da zadovoljimo duhovnog učitelja, zato što uz pomoć njegovih blagoslova duhovni napredak je moguć, a bez njegovih blagoslova to je nemoguće.
There's a famous song in this connection.
I postoji jedna poznata pesma u vezi sa ovim.
Yasya pasada bhagavatasa Asya prasadana kati kutopi
Asya prasadana prasadana Asya prasadana kati kutopi
Ayans tu mans tasya yasya smisanyam
Bez milosti duhovnog učitelja niko ne može duhovno napredovati.
Therefore, I should always remember the spiritual master. At least three times a day, I should offer my respectful obeisances unto the lotus feet of my spiritual master.
I zato, ja se trebam uvek sećati svog duhovnog učitelja i makar tri put dnevno ja mu trebam odati svoje ponizno poštovanje.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, O Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Hare Rama, Hare
of Madhavendra Puri. Whereas Ramachandra Puri received a rebuke from him.
Ishvara Puri je primio blagoslov od Madhavendra Purija, a s druge strane Ramachandra Puri je bio od njega kažnjen.
Therefore these two persons, Ishvara Puri and Ramachandra Puri, are examples of the objects of a great personality's benediction and punishment.
I zato su upravo ove dve osobe, Ishvara Puri i Ramachandra Puri, primjeri za to kako jedna velika osoba nagrađuje, odnosno blagoslovi ili kažnjava.
Madhavendra Puri instructed the whole world through the example of these two personalities.
Madhavendra Puri je poučio čitav svet kroz primjer ove dvojice ličnosti, ove dve ličnosti.
My dear devotees, you will hear first about Ishvara Puri's example and then about Ramachandra Puri's example.
Moji dragi bhakti, danas ćete prvo čuti o primjeru Ishvara Purija, a onda ćemo pričati i o Ramachandra Puriju.
You should follow the example of Ramachandra Puri and not follow Ishvara Puri. You should follow the example of Ishvara Puri and not follow the example of Ramachandra.
I vi bi trebalo da sledite primjer Ishvara Purija i da ne sledite primjer Ramachandra Purija.
You always follow examples.
Vi uvek sledite primjere.
It is natural for us.
To je prirodno za nas.
For instance, when I was young, it was inconceivable that man would have long hair.
Na primjer, kada sam ja bio mlad, to je bilo nečuveno da osoba, da muškarac ima drugu kosu.
But then the Beatles came.
Ali onda su se pojavili Beatles.
And everyone had hair like, a little like you.
I onda su svi počeli da nose ovakve frizure.
And it was social, it became acceptable. In fact, if you would not wear long hair, you were boring.
I onda ne samo da je to postalo prihvatljivo društveno, nego i ako niste imali dugu kosu, bili ste dosadni.
Everyone follows examples.
Svi slede primjer.
Yamuna is a frizerski and she knows. When the customer comes, she says, make the hair, my hair should be like Michael Jackson. You know, my hair should be like Cassius Clay, like Muhammad Ali, yes.
Yamuna to sigurno zna, ona je frizerka, tako da joj dolaze mušterije i kažu, napravi frizuru kao Michael Jackson ili kao Muhammad Ali.
Yes, no, Yamuna, yes, it is. Everyone, so here we will now, this is the human nature to follow examples.
I to je u ljudskoj prirodi da sledimo primjer.
Please hear now about the exemplary disciple Ishvara Puri, so that you can also follow this example.
I sada molim vas počnite o ovom primernom učeniku Ishvara Puriju kako biste mogli slediti njegov primjer.
Before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in this world, he sent his great devotee Madhavendra Puri to prepare the ground for his coming.
I pre nego što se Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pojavio u ovom svetu, on je poslao svog velikog baktu Madhavendra Purija kako bi on pripremio ove svet za njegov dolazak.
Madhavendra Puri had come from a higher plane. He was a tree in the spiritual world. Kind of like a tree.
I Madhavendra Puri, on je došao sa jednog višeg nivoa, on je u stvari bio drvo u duhovnom svetu.
Please do not be surprised.
Molim vas, nemojte biti iznenađeni.
On this altar you can even see stones which are conscious.
Na ovom altaru možete vidjeti čak i kamenje koje je svesno.
Because they are spiritual.
Zato što je duhovno.
Yes. In the spiritual world, everything, including the rocks and certainly the trees, is a person and is conscious and can talk to you.
i u duhovnom svetu apsolutno sve, uključujući drveće i kamenje, je osoba ima svesnost i može razgovarati sa vama.
Nothing is dead.
Tamo ništa nije mrtvo.
In Madhavendra Puri came, but he came not as a speaking tree. He came as a great saint who had many exalted disciples, including Advaitacharya, Nityananda Prabhu, and Ishvara Puri.
I Madhavendra Puri se u ovom svetu pojavio kao veliki svetac koji imao puno naprednih bhakta za svoje učenike i neki od njih su bili Advaitacharya, Ishvara Puri i Nityananda Prabhu.
All these disciples had a very distinct quality which differentiated them from all others. They were full of ecstatic love, and when they met, they sometimes danced and cried for days.
I svi ovi njegovi učenici imali su jednu osobinu koja je izdvajala od svih drugih bhakta, a to je da su bili prepuni zanosne ljubavi prema Bogu i onda kada bi se sreli, oni bi pevali i plesali u zanosu.
Finally, at the end of his mission to spread love of Godhead in this world, Madhavendra Puri became bedridden and unable to move.
I na kraju svoje misije da raširi tu ljubav prema Bogu, Madhavendra Puri je postao jako bolestan i nepokretan.
Many of his disciples visited him when he was in this condition to pay their last respects because they knew soon he would leave the world.
I mnogi njegovi učenici su ga posjetili kada je on bio u tom stanju zato što su znali da će on uskoro napustiti telo, želeli su mu odati svoje posljednje poštovanje.
One of these disciples was Ishvara Puri, who, when he saw his guru so emaciated and unable to move, saw this is a great opportunity for me to render him some service.
I jedan od tih učenika je bio Ishvara Puri, koji kada je video svog učitelja, koji je bio jako smršao i nije mogao da se kreće, on je pomislio, ovo je velika prilika za mene da služim svog duhovnog učitelja.
In this way, Ishvara Puri decided to become the Leibdiener. It means the Leibdiener, more translated, the private servant, I would say, or personal servant of Madhavendra Puri. And he did all the activities which were required, like cleaning even the urine and the, it's called, a good word is fecus. That comes out.
I onda je Ishvara Puri odlučio da on postane lični sluga Madhavendra Purija i da za njega radi sve, da se brine o njemu i da radi sve neophodne službe, čak i da se brine o tome da odstrani njegov urin i izmet.
Yes. And in order to keep the atmosphere around this great soul who was not able to move any longer very nice, Ishvara Puri would either sing the holy names or talk about Krishna.
I kako bi napravio jako lepu atmosferu oko svog duhovnog učitelja u takvom jednom stanju, Ishvara Puri je neprestano ili pevao mantra o sveto ime ili je pričao o Krishni.
In this way, Ishvara Puri perfectly helped his spiritual master to focus his mind on Krishna during these last hours in the world.
I na taj način Ishvara Puri je pomogao svom duhovnom učitelju na savršeni način da se seća Krišne u tim poslednjim trenucima života.
One day, it was just a few days before his departure, with great effort, Madhavendra Puri set up and blessed Ishvara Puri.
I samo nekoliko dana pre nego što je Madhavendra Puri napustio telo, on je sa velikim naporom se podigao na postelji seoe i dao je blagoslove Ishvara Puri.
You have served me so nice. I bless you that you obtain the pure love of Krishna.
Ti si me tako divno služio i ja te blagoslovim da ti dostigneš čistu ljubav prema Bogu.
The result of these blessings was outstanding.
I rezultat tih blagoslova je bio izvanredan.
It was as if Ishvara Puri was moved by this blessing into a great ocean of bliss which surrounded him from all sides.
I to je bilo poput toga da je Ishvara Puri uz pomoć ovih blagoslova bio prenet u okean zanosa blaženstva koji se nalazio svuda oko njega.
Then much later Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu met Ishvara Puri for the first time. He saw this personality, Ishvara Puri, is so special, I must become his disciple.
I onda mnogo kasnije, kada je Chaitanya Mahaprabhu po prvi put sreo Ishvara Purija, on je odmah pomislio, ova osoba je tako specijalna, ja želim da mi on bude duhovni učitelj.
Ishvara Puri was always crying, but happy tears of love, and it said, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was bathed by the tears of Ishvara Puri.
Ishvara Puri je uvek plakao suze, ali to su bile suze sreće od ljubavi prema Krišni i Chaitanya Mahaprabhu je bio kupan tim suzama.
Just by let us understand this, just by Madhavendra Puri wishing well for his disciple, Ishvara Puri was transported to the highest levels of love of God.
I hajde da ovo shvatimo zaista kako jeste. Samo s pomoć blagoslova Madhavendra Purija, Ishvara Puri je bio prinešen na više nivoa ljubavi prema Bogu.
Therefore it is said, it's nice if you think of a great soul, but it is much nicer if a great soul thinks of you.
I zato se kaže da je jako dobro ako mislite na uzvišenu osobu, ali još mnogo bolje ako uzvišena osoba misli na vas.
Because just his good wishes for you are having great effect on your spiritual life.
Zato što samo dobre želje te uzvišene osobe imaju tako veliki utjecaj na vaš život.
You sometimes may feel this in your life. You may feel, wow, I'm so blissful. What is different? I'm so different. My life is so different. Most probably a great soul wished you well.
I onda nekada možete osjetiti u svom životu da ste prepuni zanosa i blaženstva, možete se pitati zašto se sad ja tako osjećam, ali budite sigurni da neka uzvišena osoba misli na vas.
And sometimes we have the feeling whatever we try in life, it seems it just doesn't work out the way it should work out. It could be that you are on your own at this point.
I onda nekada također znamo i onu drugu stranu kada šta god da pokušamo ništa ne funkcioniše. I onda to najverovatnije znači da ste ostavljeni sami.
So there was another disciple also, Ramachandra Puri, who came also by to meet his spiritual master for the last time.
I to je bio još jedan drugi učenik Ramachandra Puri, koji je također došao do svog duhovnog učitelja vidi po posljednji put.
Ramachandra Puri had a psychological problem which I think most of us have. He was a little proud by nature.
I Ramachandra Puri je imao psihološki problem za koji ja smatram da ga mnogi od nas imaju i on je po svojoj prirodi bio ponosan.
But to make things worse, Ramachandra could not face his mistake.
Ali da stvari su bile još gore, zato što Ramachandra nije mogao da se suoči sa svojom greškom.
Can you see this dark spot on my hand?
Da li možete da vidite ovo tamo na ovaj predel na mojoj ruci? Da li možete?
Yeah. It's on the root of the finger.
Nalazi se upravo ovdje na korenu mog kažiprsta.
Do you know what this is? A splinter.
Da li znate šta je to? To je jedan trn.
It came in my hand 5 years ago.
I taj trn je ušao u moju ruku pre 5 godina.
But it was for me too faint, too painful to deal with it, and it came deeper and deeper and deeper in my hand.
Ali za mene je bilo previše bolno da ja izvadim taj trn i on je ulazio sve dublje i dublje u moju ruku.
That happens when you have a mistake, but you just do not face it and you don't do anything against it. It goes deeper and deeper until you cannot remove it any longer.
I to je upravo ono što se dešava kada imate grešku sa kojom ne možete da se suočite i ona sve dublje i dublje ulazi u vas.
For the rest of my life I will have this splinter in the finger.
ja ću do kraja života imati ovaj trn u ruci.
I cannot remove it any longer.
Nije moguće da se izvadi.
It's so deep.
Zato što je ušao tako duboko.
And to be quite honest with you, the splinter is not really a problem. I don't feel it.
Ali da budem iskren sa vama, to i nije neki problem jer ga ne osjećam.
But if you have a mistake and you cannot face it, the whole world will most probably see it, but if you don't face it and take it out, it goes deeper and deeper. We will watch this in the life of Ramachandra Puri now.
Ali ako imate grešku sa kojom ne možete da se suočite i najvjerojatnije svi drugi oko vas vide tu grešku, ali pošto vi nemate snage da se sukobite sa tim, ona ulazi sve dublje u dublje u vas i mi ćemo vidjeti takav primjer na životu Ramachandre Puri.
From this we can learn what we should not do.
I od njega ćemo naučiti šta ne bi trebalo da radimo.
Now, during his last time on the planet, Madhavendra Puri went into a deep mood of separation from Krishna. He would constantly lament and think of Krishna the way Radha thought of him when he had left Vrindavan to go to Mathura.
I u tim poslednjim danima pred svoju smrt Madhavendra Puri je ušao u raspoloženje velike odvojenosti od Krishne i bio u raspoloženju Shrimati Radharani kada je Krishna napustio Vrindavan.
Dayaganathe Maturanath kada alokshase Hridayam tvat alokakataram Daita pranyati kim karonyam. O my Lord, he would say, O most merciful Master, O Master of Mathura, when shall I see you again?
I onda bi on rekao, o moj gospodine, o najmilostiviji gospodaru, o gospodaru Mathure, kada ću te ja opet da videti?
Because I do not see you, my agitated heart has become unsteady.
I kako te ja ne vidim, moje uznemireno srce je postalo nemirno.
O most beloved one, what shall I do now?
O moj najvoljeniji, šta da radim sada?
In other words, towards the end of his life, Madhavendra Puri was, my life force is almost leaving me. That is not the problem. My problem is, I'm so far away from you, Krishna.
I Madhavendra Puri nije bio u raspoloženju, ah, moja životna energija me napušta, ja umirem. Ne, on je bio u raspoloženju, moj Krišna, ti si tako daleko od mene, tako daleko.
What shall I do now?
I šta sada da radim?
When Shrimati Radharani was in this state, her soft body became hot like fire.
I kada je Shrimati Radharani bila u tom stanju, njeno nežno telo je postalo vrelo poput maslaca.
Gopi assistants had collected cooling petals of the lotus flowers and had poured cool Yamuna water over it. But when Radharani lay on this, it immediately dried up.
I onda gopije, kako bi olakšale to stanje, onda su sakupile latice lotosa i također donele vodu Yamunu i kada bi Radharani legla na tu vodu, voda bi odmah se isušila.
So Ramachandra, so Madhavendra Puri felt the same pains of acute pangs of separation from Krishna.
I Madhavendra Puri je osjećao istu takvu bol te odvojenosti od Krishna, jake odvojenosti.
When Ramachandra Puri, who was visiting his Guru Maharaj, saw this, he developed a great doubt.
I kada Ramachandra Puri vidio stanje u kome se njegov duhovni učitelj nalazi, on je razvio veliku sumnju.
Oh, Guru Maharaj, this is very dangerous. Why do you become so emotional now?
Oh, Guru Maharaj, to je jako opasno. Zašto postaješ tako emotivan?
You should be fixed on the spiritual platform now. It's your death.
I ti bi trebalo da budeš ufiksiran na duhovnom nivou, to je smrt u pitanju.
Balansirati!
Balansirati.
fix your mind on Brahman.
Usredsredi svoj um na Brahman.
Ramachandra Puri thought, this is how I best can serve my spiritual master.
I Ramachandra Puri je mislio, to je najbolji način kako ja sada mogu da služim svog duhovnog učitelja.
And Ramachandra Puri heard this foolish advice. He became like a volcano.
I kada je Madhavendra Puri čuo ovaj budalasti savjet, on je postao poput vulkana.
Get this rascal out from here!
Izbacite ovog nitkova napolje.
Get him away from me!
Odmah ga odvedite dalje od mene.
If I see your face when I die, I don't know where I will be going.
I ako vidim tvoje lice, onda kada umirem, ja ne znam gde ću završiti.
Go, go, go!
Odlazi!
Sometimes the spiritual master is soft like a rose, but then he is sometimes hard like a thunderbolt.
I nekada je duhovni učitelj nežan poput ruže, a nekada je snažan poput groma.
You see, the Prabhupada commented in this connection something which is important for us to learn.
I Srila Prabhupada je dao komentar u vezi sa ovim koji je za nas jako važan.
Chanakya Pandit, Prabhupada says, advises that the father and the teacher should always criticize the disciple.
I Chanakya Pandit, on kaže da bi otac i duhovni učitelj trebalo uvek da kritikuju svog učenika.
He should always chastise him.
Oni bi uvek trebalo da ga ispravljaju, da ga kritikuju, da ga ispravljaju.
Prabhupada turns, in the lecture, Prabhupada turns to his disciples who might find it difficult. He says,
i onda Šila Prabhupada kada je to rekao na lekciji, onda se okrenuo prema svojim učenicima kojima to baš nije bilo najlakše za prihvatiti.
Don't be angry. It's the business of the teacher, the father, to simply find out your mistakes, not your good things.
I on je rekao, nemojte se brinuti, to je jednostavno posao, dužnost učitelja i oca da nađu vaše greške.
He should not pet you. Oh, my dear boy, you have done so nicely.
I on je ne trebao da vas razmaza i da kaže, o moj dragi dečeče, tako si to dobro napravio.
Yes, sometimes this is done, but in general, it is the business of the teacher, the father, to chastise.
I to je takođe nekada slučaj, ali generalno gledano, dužnost oca i učitelja jeste da ispravlja učenika ili sina.
If you simply pet, then there will be so many faults and you will spoil the disciples.
I ako ga samo mazite učenika, onda će on postati, jer imaće puno grešaka i neće ih moći ispraviti.
But if you chastise, there will come out so many good qualities.
Ali ako ga ispravljate, onda će toliko puno dobrih osobina izaći na vidu.
Prabhupada remembers in this connection how he himself was once chastised by his spiritual master, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur.
I onda se Srila Prabhupada setio o tom prilikom kako je njega samog jednom ispravio njegov duhovni učitelj, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur.
His Guru Maharaj had delivered a lecture. Prabhupada was sitting in the back of the hall, and there was an elderly gentleman who was a little hard of hearing.
I Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur je davao lekciju, a Srila Prabhupada se nalazio negde u pozadini sali gde se takođe nalazio jedan stariji gospodin koji nije baš najbolje čuo.
Sometimes he would turn to Srila Prabhupada.
I onda taj gospodin bi se ponekad okrenuo prema Prabhupada i rekao, šta je rekao, šta je rekao?
Prabhupada se...
I onda bi Prabhupada prevao bi mu šta je, ne prevao, rekao bi mu šta je rekao.
All of a sudden, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur stopped right in his lecture.
I odjedanput Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur se zaustavi u sred svoje lekcije.
He looked at Srila Prabhupada.
Pogledao Srila Prabhupada.
Hey, Babu!
Rekao je, hey, Babu!
Would you like to come here and sit and speak?
Hoćeš ti da dođeš ovde i da pričaš?
Srila Prabhupada remembered this incident 60 years after it, and he treasured it as a sign of great mercy.
I Šila Prabhupada se seća od tog događaja 60 godina nakon što se to desilo I on ga je čuvao poput dragocenosti.
He did not get up like people do. He was asking me. I was not talking. I was being resentful. No. Wow. Dobro.
I on nije ustao kako bi možda neki poput nas ustali I počeo da objašnjava, pa on me je pitao da mu kažem, nego on jednostavno rekao dobro.
I know we cannot understand this and I need to explain this a little bit more.
I meni je jasno da mi to ne možemo razumjeti I zato moram to još malo da objasnim.
There is a big thing in this world going on. It's called indifference. That means I don't care. I don't care for you. I don't care for anything.
I postoji jedna velika stvar u današnjem svetu koja se zove ravnodušnost. Znači, ja ne brinem za tebe, ja ne brinem ni za koga drugog.
What is better, if God chastises you or if he ignores you?
I šta je bolje, ako vas Bog ignoriše ili ako vas ispravlja?
Now, the third time that I speak about it, maybe I have a reason why I do this, you should ask.
I ovo je treći put da ja ponavljam istu poentu, tako da bi sad već trebalo da počnete da se pitate koji je razlog za to da ja ponavljam.
You know, Brahma had done a mistake towards Krishna.
Znate sami da je Brahma napravio grešku u vezi s Krishna.
And Krishna had chastised him in his own playful way.
I Krishna ga je ispravio, ali na svoj fini način.
Brahma came to Krishna and said, "My dear Lord, I am also a demon like these other demons which you killed. I am a Brahma Rakshasa from Satyaloka."
I onda je Brahma došao kod njega I rekao, "Moj dragi gospodine, ja sam isti ovakav demon poput ovih koje si ubio, ja sam Brahma Rakshasa sa Satyaloka."
"I have come from planet Earth just to disturb your pastimes."
I ja sam došao na planetu Zemlju samo da uznemirim tvoje zabave.
Who remembers what Brahma had done?
I ko od vas se seća šta je Brahma napravio?
Stolen the calf was. "Therefore, you should punish me like you have punished the other demons."
I zato treba da me kazniš onako kako si kaznio I ostale demone.
"You should purify me by your punishment."
I ti treba da me pročistiš svojom kaznom.
"If the servant sees that his master is either merciful or heavy on him, the servant is encouraged to continue living."
I ako sluga vidi da je njegov gospodar milostiv prema njemu ili ga kažnjava, sluga ima razloga da nastavi da živi.
"But if the servant sees that his master is indifferent towards him and does not care any longer for him, then a servant no longer desires to maintain his life."
Ali ako sluga vidi da je njegov gospodar ravnodušan prema njemu I da ga nije briga za slugu, onda sluga nema želje da nastavi svoj život.
In bhakti, it is not nice if we are moved into, if we come into a zone where the Vaishnavas, the guru, or even Krishna is indifferent.
I u bhakti procesu nije dobro, nije lepo ako dođemo u tu zonu gdje su guru ili vajšnava ili čak sam Krišna ravnodušni na nas.
So Ramachandra Puri was heaven chastised, but that was better than if his guru had been indifferent.
Tako da u ovom primjeru vidimo da je Ramachandra Puri bio jako strogo ispravljen od strane svog guru, ali to je bilo mnogo bolje nego da je Madhavendra Puri bio ravnodušan prema njemu.
Because by this chastisement, purification happened.
Zato što s pomoć tog ispravljanja došlo je do pročišćenja.
We say this sometimes, it is called, "Oh, I'm going through some purification problem."
I mi imamo tu izreku među nama u Iskonu, mi kažemo da, prolazim kroz neko pročišćenje.
It's passionate language as we, you know, we do this.
To je jezik koji koristimo.
Because what we mean is, if we have shown a mistake has come out,
And now we get the chastisement. We will not have to suffer any karmic things.
Zato što mi znamo, ako napravimo grešku i ako smo onda ispravljeni na neki način, onda znamo da ne moramo da prođemo kroz karmičke posledice tog čina koji smo napravili.
But Madhavendra Puri also stopped wishing for the welfare of Ramachandra.
Ali Madhavendra Puri u isto vreme prestao da ima i dobre želje za Ramachandra Puri.
Let's see what happened to Ramachandra's psychology as the thorn, that is his arrogance, was driven deeper into his flesh.
I hajde sada da pogledamo šta se desilo Ramachandra Puriju kada je taj trn njegove arogancije počeo da zaranja dublje i dublje u njegovo tkivo.
He thought, I am a serious, sincere disciple of my spiritual master. And now where he has gone, I should also take up the role of instructing others. My role is to chastise the devotees.
I kada je Madhavendra Puri otišao, onda je Ramachandra Puri zaključio kako je on iskren i ozbiljan bhakta i da je njegova uloga da i on počne da daje instrukcije bhaktama i te njegove instrukcije su u stvari trebale biti te da on ispravlja drugi.
Prabhupada said that now Ramachandra Puri became expert in seeing faults in the devotees. There are actually no faults there. Jai Jagannath, wonderful. You are carrying God, Ananda Gopal. Do you know this?
I Ramachandra Puri je sada postao stručnjak u nalaženju grešaka u drugim.
I heard once he became nishta in fault finding.
I ja sam čuo da je on postao postojan sasvim u pronalaženju greški kod drugih. Dostigao je taj nivo ništa.
In our movement we also have a few nishta devotees in this way.
I kod nas u pokretu imamo takođe nekoliko takvih bhakta koji su na tom nivou.
So, when he came to Jagannath Puri, Ramachandra made up his mind, I will investigate this ecstatic sannyasi from Bengal, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
I kada je Ramachandra Puri došao u Jagannath Puri, onda je on odlučio, sad ću ja da ispitam ovog ekstatičnog sannyasija iz Bengala.
But he thought, let me start with his disciples.
Ali onda je mislio, da ja prvo počnem sa njegovim učenicima.
So one day he invited Jagannanda Pandit and served him prasadam.
I onda on jednog dana pozvao Jagannanda Pandita i služio mu je prasada.
Maha prasada.
Maha prasada, gospodina Jagan.
And Jagannanda Pandit came to the stage where he said, enough.
I Jagannanda Puri je, Pandit je došao nakon nekog vremena do tog stanja kada više jednostavno nije mogao da je.
Ramachandra said, do you neglect to accept the Mahaprasada of Lord Jagannath?
I onda je Ramachandra Puri rekao, zar ti odbijaš da prihvatiš Mahaprasada gospodina Jagannatha?
Take more, it's Mahaprasada.
Uzmi još, to je Mahaprasada.
Jagannanda thought that this is the god brother of Ishvara Puri. He should not protest, he's a senior Vaishnava.
I onda je Jagannanda Pandit mislio, pa dobro, ali ovo je god brother od Ishvara Purija, ja ne bi trebalo da protestujem.
And he politely continued to eat until he absolutely could not eat more.
I onda je on i dalje nastavio da jede sve dok stvarno više nije mogao ništa da pojede.
When he was finished, Ramachandra said, ha! Now I have seen it. The followers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu eat too much.
I kada je on završio, onda je Ramachandra Puri rekao, aha, sad sam se uverio, sledbenici Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, oni se prejedaju.
How will you advance if you are such wolf-like eaters?
I kako vi možete da napredujete kada jedete poput vukova?
So if you continue to find fault with Vaishnavas, one day that will not be enough for you, then you will find fault with the Lord also. So Ramachandra came one day when it was noontime and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was eating. He came to him and sat in the corner.
I ako nastavite da nalazite greške u bhaktama, onda vam to neće biti dovoljno, tako da ćete jednog dana početi da nalazite greške i u samom Krišni. Isto tako, Ramachandra Puri je jednog dana došao po Chaitanya Mahaprabhuva kada je on častio prasadam i seo je nedaleko od njega.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu immediately got up and arranged a seat and said to Govinda, his servant, the godbrother of my guru has come, please serve him also for prasadam.
I Chaitanya Mahaprabhu je odmah ustao i rekao je Govindi, rekao je, molim te, ovo je brat po Bogu mog duhovnog učitelja, molim te se posluži mu lepo prasadu.
I just came to associate with you.
I Ramachandra Puri je rekao, ne, ja sam samo došao da se družim sa tobom.
And he stared from the corner.
I on je gledao pozorno iz ugla.
Ramachandra, very uncomfortable, but godbrother of his guru Maharaj, so he can't lead him.
I gospodin Chaitanya se ni malo, nije osjećao ni malo prijatno, ali mislio je, pa dobro, ali to je brat mog duhovnog učitelja. I onda je on nastavio da je.
He felt highly uncomfortable.
I on se osjećao jako neprijatno.
Yesterday Jai Krishna from London ate and there was a dog before him who stared on his plate.
I juče je Jai Krishna iz Londona jeo, ispred njegovog tanjira se nalazio pas koji je zurio neprekidno ono što je.
I told him, you will get indigestion, you better go with your plate. Give something to the dog that he's satisfied and then go somewhere else. You should not eat if someone stares on your plate.
Ja sam mu rekao, sigurno nećeš moći da svariš to što si pojeo kada neko tako zuri u tvoj tanjir. Daj malo prasadama psu i onda idi dalje odatle.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had to continue. Ramachandra came the next day and also the next day.
Ali Chaitanya Mahaprabhu je morao da nastavi da jede, a Ramachandra Puri je došao i sledećeg i onog narednog dana.
One day, but he just couldn't find any fault.
Ali on jednostavno nije mogao da nađe nijednu grešku.
Then he saw some ants in Jagannath Puri. And then he said, now I see. Ants means there must be sweets. So this sannyasi, most probably, not for sure, he eats sweets secretly in the night.
I onda je on video mrave u sobi gospodina Chaitanya i onda je rekao, sad znam, ovaj sannyasi sigurno krije slatkiše koje onda jede kradom noću.
Now you can ask Kishori and Madhva Muni how many ants there are in the kitchens in Puri. It is too much.
A možete pitati Kishori i Madhva koliko mrava ima u kuhinjama u Jagannath Puriju, to je stvarno previše.
I'm seeing Kishori, she's an authority of how to make an arrangement that the ants cannot plunder your supplies.
A ja vidim Kishori, ona je tu u uglu i ona je stručnjak za to kako da napravi aranžman da vam mravi ne dođu u prasadu.
One method is to put a little rope from the ceiling and then hang your supplies there. But if the ants after some time will find out, they will move up the ceiling, go on the ceiling, go down the rope and eat.
Jedan metod koji postoji jeste da okačite, da stavite jedan konopac na tavanicu, da ga zakačite i da onda na njega okačite ono što imate, ali nakon nekog vremena mravi će se uspeti po zidu i opet će doći i naći vaše zalihe.
There are always ants.
Tamo uvek ima mrava.
Everywhere.
Svuda.
It's not right that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ate sweets and they were on the floor and therefore the ants were there.
I to nije bilo ispravno da je Chaitanya Mahaprabhu jeo slatkiše i da je onda napravio mrve po podu i da su zato tamo bili mrave.
They are there anyways.
Oni su tu i onako, uvek.
I have seen this when devotees sometimes quarrel, it's not really about the thing, it's just about their egos.
Ja sam to isto vidio nekada kada se bhakte prepiru među sobom, da se uopšte ne radi o nekoj konkretnoj stvari, samo se radi o egu.
And anyways, when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard this, he said, Govinda, just give me half of what you usually serve me.
I onda kada je gospodin Čajtanja čuo tu primjedbu, on je rekao Govindi, dobro, daj mi molim te samo polovinu onoga što mi inače služiš.
Maybe then Ramachandra Puri is satisfied that's no longer go on the internet and spread lies.
I možda će onda Ramachandra Puri biti zadovoljan nama i neće otići na internet da širi laži.
But Ramachandra Puri came after some time and said, you look so thin. Do you think by dry renunciation you can advance?
I onda Ramachandra Puri je došao nakon nekog vremena i rekao, ti si tako smršao, pa misliš da samo odvojenošću možeš da dostigneš ljubav prema Bogu.
Eventually Ramachandra Puri left Puri and everyone be like,
I onda... Nakon nekog vremena Ramachandra Puri je otišao iz Jagannath Purija i svi su odahnuli da ga je već nema.
Because when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cut his eating into half, all his devotees cut his eating into half.
Zato što kada je Chaitanya Mahaprabhu počeo da časti samo polovinu onoga što bi normalno častio i sve njegove bhakti su napravile istu stvar.
And when Ramachandra finally left Puri to go somewhere else, everyone died. Krishna's milost.
I kada Ramachandra Puri najzad otišao iz Jagannath Purija, svi bhakti su odahnuli i mislili su da je to stvarno Krišnjena milost.
Ramachandra offended and offended and offended that eventually he turned into a Mayavadi.
I Ramachandra Puri je nastao da na taj način iznova i iznova vređe bhakte dok se nije pretvorio u Mayavadi.
This is what happens when there are Vaishnava offenses. You know, the thorn goes deeper, deeper and deeper until you can't remove it any longer.
I to je upravo ono što se dešava ako pravimo uvrede prema baktama. Taj trn, on ulazi dublje, dublje i dublje i na kraju ga ne možemo više izvaditi.
There's so much suffering comes by this, you can't imagine.
I to donosi toliko puno patnje, ne možete to zamisliti.
And the result is everyone loses faith in Krishna.
A rezultat je da svi izgube veru u Krishna.
Now, there's an important lesson here. We should not think that Ramachandra Puri is bad. No, he's actually very good.
I sada postoji jako važna poenta u ovoj lekciji. Mi ne bi trebalo da mislimo da je Ramachandra Puri bio loš. On je u stvari jako dobar.
He is a liberated associate of Lord Krishna.
On je oslobođen i pratilac gospodina Krishna.
In Krishna Lila, he's actually the stepmother of Radharani, Jatila.
I on je u Krišnjenim zabavama mačeha Šimati Radharani, ne mačeha, nego kako se to kaže, svekrva Šimati Radharani, Jatila.
Jatila always makes some weird arrangements so that there are some wonderful pastimes happening.
I Jatila uvek pravi te neke jako čudne aranžmane tako da se dešavaju prelepe zabave.
I remember one thing Bhakti Charu Maharaj told me. Radha and Krishna were just very confidentially exchanging the divine Leela in the room when all of a sudden Jatila stormed into the room.
Ja se sećam jedne zabave koju je ispričao Bhaktičaru Maharaj i on kaže da su Radha i Krishna nalazili su se upravo zajedno u sobi u jako poverljivoj razmeni i onda je Jatila umarširala u sobi.
Krishna somehow escaped by his antartana shakti, his invisible shakti.
I Krishna na neki način pobegao u svoju moć nestaje nevidljivosti.
But it was so fast his flute remained on lying on the bed of Radharani.
Ali on je bio tako brz da je njegova flauta ostala na krevetu Šimati Radharani.
Ah, said Jatila, I have the corpus delict.
I onda Jatila se nasmela, rekla, aha, sad imam dokaz.
And she ran out and said, oh, good people of Braj, of Vrindavan, come together. Look what I found on the bed of my daughter-in-law. It's the flute of the womanizer Krishna. She...
I onda ona rekla, dobri ljudi Vrindavana, okupite se ovde da vidite šta sam ja našla na krevetu svoje snaje. To je flauta ovog prevrtljivca Krišna.
What will the flute of this person do alone? He was in that room.
I šta bi, kako bi se ta flauta tu našla sama od sebe? On je bio u sobi.
Oh, the bush passes. Flute, the Krishna's flute came from the room. Krishna must have been with Radharani, although she is married.
I onda svi bridge basi su rekli, pa da, to je Krišnina flauta, on mora da je bio sa Šrimati Radharani, iako je ona udata.
Purnamasi spoke up.
I onda je Purnamasi progovorila.
Oh, good people of Vrindavan, you have lost your intelligence.
O dobri ljudi Vrindavana, vi ste izgubili svoju inteligenciju.
Don't you know that this night there was a flute shower in Vrindavan? The flute were raining into the beds of all good people?
Zar niste videli da je ove noći padala kiša flauta i da su flaute završile u krevetima svih dobrih ljudi Vrindavana?
Look at your own rooms!
Pogledajte u svoju sobstvenu sobu.
We are here in Vrindavan, said the bridge buses, everything is possible. And they went into their rooms and everyone found in their bed, on their beds, one or two or three flutes.
I onda oni su pomislili, pa ovdje smo u Vrindavan, ovdje je sve moguće. Otišli su kući, pogledali u krevete i našli jednu, dve ili čak tri flaute.
And they all came back to Yatila, because your intelligence is crooked. You have a crooked interpretation of the very natural thing that was a flute shower in the night.
I onda su se oni svi vratili kod Jatile i rekli su, kako ti imaš tu prevrtljivu prirodu, onda imaš i tu prevrtljivu interpretaciju jednog sasvim prirodnog fenomena. Padala je kiša flauta.
Natural harmony fenomena. But you... Do you drink enough milk?
Da li piješ dovoljno mlijeka?
So Yatila serves a purpose in Krishna's amazing, surprising and joyful pastimes.
Tako da Yatila ima sasvim određenu ulogu i svrhu u Krišninim predivnim zabavama.
And Yatila came at that Rama Chandrapuri. Why? He had a mission to teach us what we should not do.
I Jatila se pojavila u zabavama Chaitanya Mahaprabhu kao Ramachandrapuri kako bi nas poučila šta ne bi trebalo da radimo.
I would like to summarize and then give you a very interesting exercise for the day.
Ja bih sada želeo da sažmem čitavu lekciju i da vam onda dam jednu dobru praksu za ostatak dana.
From this pastime we should learn to appreciate the good qualities of devotees.
Iz ove zabave trebalo bi da naučimo da cenimo dobre odlike bhakta.
We should not try to look for faults.
I mi ne bi trebalo da pokušavamo da nađemo greške.
Prabhupada said we should be like nectar bees who always look for the honey and not like flies who look for the open wounds.
I mi bi trebali bismo biti, kao što to Prabhupada kaže, poput pčela koje uvijek traže nektar, a ne bismo trebali biti poput muva koje uvijek lete na otvorene rane.
Now you might just finally ask, but wait, Maharaj, why do you all, we don't want to hear always these simplified explanations. We like to go into the detail.
Ali onda biste mogli sad reći, da, ali Maharaj, mi ne volimo da uvijek čujemo ove pojednostavljene primere. Mi želimo sad da idemo u detalje.
What is this false?
Šta sa greškama?
Should we just see, not see them?
Da li ne trebamo uopšte da ih vidimo?
I have to a surprise for you. False will always be there.
Ja imam iznenađenje za vas, greške će uvek biti prisutne.
Because everyone has his own karma and his own qualities and in some combinations the quality of some person is a fault, in another combination it's a virtue.
I svako od nas ima svoju karmu i svoje odlike osobine i u jednom slučaju kod jedne osobe ista osobina će biti greška, a kod druge osobe ta osobina će biti vrlina.
The instruction is you should not praise someone and you should not find faults, because both praise and faults is dealing with material qualities in a relative world.
I vi jednostavno ne bi trebalo niti da hvalite nekoga, ali niti da ga kudite i da nalazite greške, zato što je sve to na materijalnom nivou.
Vata, 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 vata to say this is good or to say this is bad is a mental conception only.
I kada kažemo da je nešto dobro ili da je nešto loše, to je jednostavno materijalni koncept.
I may like the fiery temperament of let me call him Govinda Charandas.
I meni može da se dopada vatreni temperament Govinda Charandas.
I feel this man can move something.
Zato što ja osjećam da to, da taj čovjek može nešto da pokrene.
He has an intelligence.
On ima inteligenciju.
He is a good in a place.
I on
He's good in a place.
I on je dobar na tom položaju da jest.
But another person who has another character will say, oh, this Govinda Charan gets on my nerves.
Ali druga osoba koja ima drugačiju perspektivu reći će, ovo je Govinda Charan mi ide na živce.
It's just material qualities. My material qualities and his qualities interacting. Sometimes the biochemistry fits and sometimes it does not fit.
Ali to su jednostavno materijalne osobine i čista hemija u pitanju. Nekada ta hemija se slaže, a nekada ne.
We are spiritualists.
Mi smo duhovne osobe.
We are not concerned with material qualities.
Nas ne zanimaju materijalne osobine.
Only when Govinda Charan's fiery nature begins to cause harm to devotees something in the service goes wrong, then we should direct Govinda Charan.
I samo u tom slučaju kada ta vatrena priroda Govinda Charana počinje da nanosi štetu bhaktama ili službi, samo onda bi trebalo da se umeša.
In other words, tolerate the so-called faults.
Drugim rečima, tolerišete te takozvane greške.
Once one of my god brothers came to Prabhupada and complained about another god brother and asked, what should I do?
Jedan od mojih braća po Bogu otišao kod Šila Prabhupada, žalio se na drugog svog brata po Bogu i rekao je Prabhupada, što sada radi?
And Prabhupada said, you should tolerate him just like I tolerate you.
I Prabhupada mu odgovorio, treba da ga tolerišeš upravo onako kako što ja tolerišem tebe.
Today we will go in the streets of Novi Sad.
Danas idemo na ulice Novog Sada.
You will see devotees dancing.
Vidjet ćete bhakte kako plešu.
Some dancing you will like.
Neko plesanje ćete voleti.
Some dancing you will not like.
A neko vam se neće svidjeti.
Some kirtan you will find ecstatic, some kirtan you will find too much.
I neki kirtan će vam biti ekstatičan, a neki drugi će vam biti previše.
Some devotee will sweat and will smell.
I neki bhakti će se znojiti i ne mirisati.
Another will be very fragrant.
A neki drugi će biti jako mirisan.
Don't see these material qualities today.
Nemojte danas da vidite te materijalne osobine.
Try to see the devotee spiritually.
Pokušajte da vidite bhakte duhovnim očima.
See the good qualities they are chanting for Krishna.
I vidite njihove dobre osobine, oni mantraju za Krishna.
There is a verse which most of you will know.
Ima jedan stih koji većina vas poznaje.
I doubt that you know the translation, but I think you say it often. I will say it a bit in Sanskrit and translate.
Ja znam da znate sanskrit, ali nisam siguran da znate i prevod, tako da ću reći ovo.
It is a verse which encourages us to see Mahaprasad, Vaishnavas, Govinda and the holy name in a spiritual way.
I to je stih koji nas ohrabruje da vidimo Mahaprasada, Vaishnave i Krishnu na duhovan način.
Mahaprasade Govinde,
Mahaprasade Govinde,
Nama Brahmani Vaishnave,
Nama Brahmani Vaishnave,
Svalpa Punyavatam Rajan, Vishvaso Naiva Jayate. Oh my god, this is the last. I know we have to now go. No?
Yeah, the
Lord those who have very few pious activities to their credit can never develop faith in these four items.
One osobe koje imaju jako malo pobožnih zasluga nikada ne mogu razviti veru u sljedeće stvari.
Mahaprasad, Sri Govinda, the holy name and the Vaishnavas.
Mahaprasad, Sri Govindu, u sveto ime i u Vaishnava.
This verse means in essence develop faith in Mahaprasad and Govinda, the holy name or in the Vaishnavas.
I ovaj stih nam govori o razvijanju vere u Mahaprasadam, Govindu, u sveto ime i Vaishnava.
See the good.
Vidite dobro.
See things spiritually.
Vidite stvari duhovnim očima.
Tell your mind to go away when it finds fault, when it suffers the Ramachandra Puri complex.
I recite svom umu da ode dalje od vas kada pati od tog sindroma Ramachandra Puri.
Learn to be like Ishvara Puri.
I naučite da budete poput Ishvara Puri.
Today.
Danas.
Tomorrow I will ask you how well you did.
A sutra ću vas pitati kako vam je to pošlo za ruku.
I want to end here. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Sri Ishvara Puri ki jai, Sri Madhavendra Puri ki jai, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki jai, Sri Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Devi ki jai, Gaura Premanandi ki jai,
Sri Chaitanya Maharaja ki jai.